something to it. So if you guys have any ideas.
Ideas for?
For this riff, like where to bridge it.
I'll grab it.
Add
it.
Play your local there.
Number three, my friend Chung Bao, this year was the world champion beatboxer. He's from Vietnam.
Mm-hmm.
He did a live performance. It's an EP that is not mastered. So.
Oh, that's great though. Thanks. Thanks. Mistake. That's good.
I learned from Joni Mitchell too. I love those beautiful mistakes. I mean, when it comes to recording and even perfection, but the beautiful mistakes are how creation works.
That's in an interview Leo Kottke did with Nash Sunday Morning Public Radio about 20 years ago. He talks about how he likes great mistakes.
I do too.
It's a great interview. It's on Minnesota Public Radio with John.
Gong? John Gong?
Not John Dong, but the guy that interviews him is. Bill McLaughlin interviews Leo Kottke. It's a great interview.
website's on there if you want to find me on anything.
Just do love, for sure.
It's got my like, Instagram and shit on my website.
Can I send you a message on that website?
Yeah, on the email or on
the site.
I'll remind you about the Leo Cocky. Maybe I'll find out if he's going to play live some reason.
Yeah, I can't spend $70 on tickets.
Well, no, they're not that much. The general in-house for the live theater for Milwaukee. I think they're probably like 20 grand. But the upfront seats are solid. The upper seats are 70 that my daughter wants to get. That's what?
Okay, well, yeah. Technically, it's cheaper.
Yeah.
Because usually with Fingerstyle artists, you have a chance to meet them and they have a show and talk to them.
Yeah, well, Cocky does this. He comes to places like the day before the event and he used to play like a boy's books for free. It would crowd in hundreds of people. Music was the Anyway, thanks for it's Mark Seibold, yeah. Do you use Facebook?
I do.
Alright. We'll send you a request. You can send me one.
I'll have to send it. Give me your information when you email me because I have a blog on Facebook.
Okay. Alright. Alright, great.
Thank you.
It's really great. It's so refreshing to walk up and hear this. From behind, I hate to say, I expected to see a guy playing.
Oh, normally.
And when I got there, I saw an attractive woman playing this. Well, I thought, wow, what a surprise.
Oh, right.
So.
Normally, like, I don't even get into detail. People are like, what do you do? I'm like, play guitar. And they're like, are you in a band? I'm like, no. Do you sing? No. And they're just like, oh, well, I don't really know what you do. And I'm like, I can't explain it.
Just what you're doing is great. If you just keep doing what you do.
But you said Joni Mitchell. She's definitely a huge inspiration on opening your mind. Yeah. I've never had a guitar lesson in my life. Like, I don't know anything about
music. Some of the best performance artists didn't have lessons.
Learning that fact.
She was self-taught, I think.
Helped me keep going.
Yeah.
You know, being like, the people I adore didn't have lessons either. Because
right.
Every time I've been in a band, they make me feel insufficient, feel inferior.
Oh, it's too bad.
I'm like, oh, I don't know what key I'm in.
Yeah.
No, you don't need to know.
The Beatles were self-taught.
Really?
Yeah, pretty much.
I don't know, they laid out the platform for most.
Most, yeah, I'm of that generation, like your parents or maybe your grandparents. Well, that saw them in 1964.
My parents aren't musicians in any way. My friends, though, I feel like the Beatles were how they learned their bass lines, how they learned all their stuff. You know, it was always the Beatles. The Beatles. I had friends from Columbia who were just obsessed with the Beatles.
Well, they caused a huge world sensation.
Yeah.
Worldwide.